Let's learn how to create and update Business Glossary assets using Business Glossary Workflow, which was introduced in InfoSphere Business Glossary 8.7 and enhanced in a patch to InfoSphere Business Glossary 9.1. The patch has been available since April 2013. The two main benefits of Workflow are, number one, we can develop glossary content, terms, categories, policies, and rules in a separate logical partition without touching the glossary that ordinary users access. And number two, the glossary changes in this development environment can be reviewed, approved, and published before they can be viewed by the general audience. Let's get up and running in three steps. First, while logged in as Business Glossary Administrator, we find the Workflow Management screen and turn it on. Second, we add Business Glossary users as workflow participants and assign editor, reviewer, approver, and publisher workflow roles to the glossary and governance team members. Each workflow role gives users certain capabilities. Editors create and update content. Reviewers can review the content. Approvers approve the content, and after it is approved and ready for deployment throughout the enterprise, publishers publish that content. As we can see when assigning workflow roles, not all users can be assigned to all workflow roles. The Business Glossary Security role of the user controls what workflow roles are available. Editors and publishers must have the Business Glossary Author Security role. Reviewers and approvers can have the less privileged Business Glossary User Security role. Here, we'll give Eddie the editor role, Anne the approver role, and we'll make Pat the publisher. And, although they are not required to make the workflow feature operable, will enable other users to review. They'll be able to see and comment upon, but not change, items in the development glossary. Notice that it's also possible for one user to have a combination of workflow capabilities. Here, for example, we give Omni the editor, approver, and publisher roles, so that she can fully control the lifecycle of her content by herself. Once enabled, we can see that our single glossary duplicated itself, and we now have a development glossary in addition to a published glossary. Now let's move to step 3, determining subject area ownership with development glossary permissions. Per category, I can declare that only certain users or groups will be responsible. To be listed here, users and groups must have a workflow role, such as we just assigned. Let's say that Eddie, Anne, and Pat are on the governance team for the claims category. We'll give them and all of the reviewers permissions to that category and all of its subcategories. Omni, though, has permissions to the legal category. This separation of ownership ensures not only that the right people are working in their areas of expertise, but that no toes are stepped on and there are no dependencies between departments, projects, or any other division within the glossary team. We're done setting up now. We've enabled workflow, assigned capabilities, and assigned development glossary category permissions, so let's get to work. We'll log out and then come back in as Eddie, one of our editors. Let's watch Eddie as he updates an existing term and then creates a new one. For the term agent, he simply needs to add a steward. And the new term, broker, he adds to the claims category. These two terms are now in the draft state, the first of three workflow states that new or changed content must pass through before being published. Drafts can be sent for approval one at a time or in a batch, as we see here. A brief comment will help the reviewers and approver, anyone who views the asset within the development glossary, understand the context, intention, or specifics of the changes. Any user who has a workflow role can view assets in the development glossary. Let's look at the two terms we are working on from the point of view of reviewer Rita. In the assets pending approval, Rita notices that the term broker was created without a description. She enters a comment mentioning this. Notice that users with any workflow role can view and comment upon assets that are in any workflow state. When Eddie looks at the development log for the term broker, he can see this comment from Rita. He returns the term to draft so that he can edit it. Eddie enters the missing description and sends the term for approval. Let's switch to the point of view of Anne, the approver who works with Eddie. She needs to review the two terms that are pending approval. The first term looks good, worthy of approval. Some reviewers had issues with the definition of broker, which we can see from their comments in the development log. All users with workflow roles can see comments from each other, enabling collaboration among as large a group of users as is needed. Now, Anne makes her own comment on this and sends broker back to draft. Back to Eddie's perspective. We see that there are no more items pending approval, but here is the term that was returned to draft by Anne. Eddie makes his changes, saves, and sends it once again for approval. Back to Anne, who checks her items pending approval and approves this latest change. Now Pat, our publisher, can publish the approved terms. Pat goes ahead and publishes the changes. Now the job is done. We see our new and revised terms in the published glossary. Our controlled, governed development process, now enabling participation by more members of the enterprise, has yielded trustworthy new content for the benefit of all.